characters are all have very complicated motivations and kind of cross agendas and cross purposes and fate and the war and the different nationalities have forced a lot of people to use each other in ways that aren't personal but are kind of tragic. And but each of them has a motivation that's very, very personal and specific.
And you have a man that arrives in the town looking, expecting one thing and finding out something else, and then embarks on a journey to find the truth, and along that way falls in love with a woman, finds out what happened to his friend, and the world collapses around him at that time. And I think that that's an amazingly, you know, interesting story.
My friend was an American agent.
What was he working on?
He was investigating a local gang lord called Anthony Lantine.
Maybe you say that this is a very traditional love story or historical war movie, which is not. We are talking about a love story, a passion, not only man and woman. It's about the relationship man and man.
Did you find out who they were?
I will.
One moment I saw you try to kill him, the next I saw you try to save his life.
And never do anything to hurt him.
You know, the first thing that always has to attract you is the script. And the script is, you know, it's this great, great adventure, this great coming together of all these forces there in Shanghai.
Welcome to Shanghai.
Not related too much about the political issues at all.
There is no, I don't think you could, I don't think there's a bad guy in it. There are people who feel like they would be the bad guy. But in truth, all the characters are much richer than just being the good guy or the bad guy.
The human dignity in that period is very interesting. It's not about all about money. It's all about interests, friendships.
There's nothing that you can do now. Just get the hell out of Shanghai.
Your friend, your husband, for what?
You think one life makes a difference?
Historic is always interesting because you can do a lot of research, and there's beautiful costumes involved and all that.
You remember Mrs. Miller?
Yes, of course.
Would you like to join us? Would you like to sit down?
I'm meeting some friends.
I don't know a better international cast of actors in the world. It's just an amazing cast, and I feel really lucky to be part of it. So,
I mean, John Cusack, Gong Li, Ken Watanabe, Chow Yun Fat, David Morse. We have this amazing group, again, a core group of actors, and that then filters to all to everybody else that we have.
Paul Soames,
Anthony Lantin,
my wife Anna.
How do you do? It's
a pleasure to meet you, ma'am.
I'm a massive fan of Chow Yun Fat from The Killers. Yeah, he's a great fan of his as well.
It's not a typical gangster in Shanghai during the 1940s. We also have a big heart. It's not only black and white. We also have a gray area in the middle. Just love it.
I mean, I feel like I'm working with the very best actors in Asia, really.
A few years ago, I'd have cut his throat for even looking at her.
I think this is kind of a character, me and Gong Li, is always interesting. You don't know, they are only friends, or husband and wife, or partner, you know. We still have a lot of different mysterious substance inside the story and the character itself.
Put her into that milieu and you see her walking on the street with 1,000 extras and a four-story set of Shanghai built for four blocks. It's not hard to imagine her as Anna. So a lot of the work's done for you.
so soon?
Yeah, I think so.
You were talking to Captain Tanaka.
Yes, we were both admiring your skill at convincing every man in the room that he meant something to you.
The first time I worked with a European director, it was pretty unique. He gave you tons of different choices and tons of different questions. And you have to analyze it, which way he won. And he's very precise, say, Anthony, maybe, or maybe not, that is. He gives you more room to create your own way.
In Shanghai, in China, there's a film studio that has a standing set for 1940s of the Nanjing Road, which is a lot of the films that take place in this era shoot there. But nobody has recreated sort of the what they call the Bund, which is the main waterway and old classic buildings in Shanghai. And, you know, our film is set in the beginning and as an arrival there, and then in the departure through the chaos of the Japanese invasion and leaving the city behind. And that port has never been sort of conceived or recreated for any film. And we've rebuilt that basically through CG and through set construction to have this port of Shanghai.
But Shanghai haunted me. So I returned to her.
That you can do now. Just get the hell out of Shanghai.
Are you still in love with him?
You don't understand anything.
You used everybody. Your friends, your husband, for what?
You think one life makes a difference?
Welcome to Shanghai.